friction. Need for friction. What does friction do? It opposes motion, so it slows things down. We do try our best to reduce friction in many places. But keep in mind that friction is not necessarily a bad thing. There are many places where not having enough friction becomes a problem. What happens if you run down the footpath and you try to stop on a puddle? Friction is still there, but the liquid makes the surface smoother and the friction is a lot less. Less friction means it is harder to stop. Ice in contact with steel produces lesser friction than rubber wood on concrete. This is why ice skates slide so easily on the ice, but you don't slip when wearing rubber shoes on the footpath. The low friction thing happens to cars when it rains. That's why there are often so many accidents. Even though the friction of the brakes is still there, the brakes may be wet and the wheels are not in as much contact with the ground. Cars may hydroplane when they go too fast on puddles of water. You can look up what hydroplaning means if you want to explore it further. Yes or no? If a car needs to stop at a signal, it slows because of the friction between the brakes and the wheels. Yes. If you run down the footpath and stop quickly, you can stop because of the friction between your shoes and the cement. Yes. If there was no friction, we would just be sliding around everywhere. So friction helps us keep steady. Friction is used in car brakes and when we walk or even climb a hill. The fire that early man made was also because of friction. This shows that sometimes we want to reduce friction and sometimes we want to increase it. Let's look at other places where we try to increase the friction. Basically, you know now that friction gives grip. So whenever you need more grip, you go in for more friction. Look at the grooves on the tire of your car. What are they for? To increase the friction so that the tires grip the road better. If the grooves, which are also called treads, wear out, tire can slip on the road and the vehicle can have an accident. So, if you have a car, keep checking the condition of the treads. If they are getting worn out, you have to replace the tires. All tires do eventually get worn out and have to be replaced. How quickly this happens depends on various factors like driving habits, where you live, and how well you care for your tires. If you have a car, check out your tire carefully. Is a certain part of your tire more worn out than the others? This is often the case in cities with lots of roundabouts, and if your tire is wearing unevenly, this can affect your steering and braking distances. When you're replacing tires, it is best to replace all four at once. If not, then make sure you replace both the front ones or the back ones. Tires normally have to be changed roughly every 25,000 kilometers. If you are a rough driver, then it may have to be changed even before that. Even if you don't drive much, you will still have to change tires in 3 to 4 years because the rubber can get cracked. Tires age too. Have you ever wondered what happens to your old tires? The really big truck tires are retreated. That means The rubber that comes in contact with the road is removed and replaced. This can be done to tires that are only worn out. If the tire is very old, then retreading is not done. Tires that cannot be retreated cannot be used as rubber again, as a lot of processing is done on it to make it hard. They can just be used as landfill or in furniture design or decorations. As such tires cannot be recycled, they are quite the environmental hazard. Coming back to friction, where else do you try to increase friction? Have you seen how the surface of staircases or footpaths in public places is made very rough? That is to increase the friction so that people do not slip and fall. What about the soles of your shoes? There are treads there too. You need those especially on your trekking shoes and the rainy wear shoes. Have you seen the shoes that trekkers wear on ice? They have spikes and chains on them to make them even rougher. Football players wear cleats. Those have spikes or cleats on them. They give more grip to the players when they run on the field. They run very fast and keep changing directions. So not slipping is very important. People who live in snowy areas have to put chains on their car tires in the winter to make them even rougher. That is the only way they can drive and stay safe. More friction is very important in that situation. You put grips on your bicycle handle or on your bike handle. What is that for? It is to increase the friction so that your hand does not slide off when you hold it. It gives you better grip even if your palm becomes sweaty. In fact, you see this grip in many places. You see them on cricket bats, tennis rackets, badminton rackets, table tennis bats, and basically any equipment that you need to hold on to. In sports, your palms are going to get sweaty. Therefore, the grip becomes really important. You may have grabbed a towel to help you grip a slippery lid of a jar to open it. Even here, you increased the friction to have better grip so that you could open the jar. And look at your fingers. You have treads there too. Even on the toes of your feet, you have treads. These treads are only near the tips of your fingers, not everywhere on your hand. In fact, other than these places, you don't find these anywhere on your skin. Why? For friction, for better grip. When your hand is oily or powdery, these treads become smoother and the oil or powder evens out the bumps. Then, things start slipping out of your hand. And what do people call you then? Butterfingers. You know how butter on your fingers can reduce your grip now. You know that you couldn't walk without friction. You couldn't even write without friction. The friction between the pencil and the paper makes some pieces of the graphite rub off on the paper and you can see the writing. When you strike a matchstick on the rough surface of the matchbox, friction causes a spark. Then, the materials on the tip of the match use that spark to start burning. What did we just learn? Friction is important for many of our activities. Friction can be increased by making a surface rough. The sole of the shoes and the tires of the vehicle are treated to increase friction. The friction is sometimes undesirable.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.